which is the intoxicant, which is haram. Let's say if a person is taking painkillers as a drug, it is not no more something that is a medicine. Now, it goes to the asal, which is what? Which is intoxicant. If a person is not sick, he's taking painkillers because he want to get high. It's not like he came out of surgery where the doctor gave him few pills to take because of the pain is unbearable. Now, this person doesn't have nothing. He's, alhamdulillah, but he's taking painkillers because that get him high. Right? Now, so therefore here, barakallahu feekum, and here the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, he said that the first issue is that annahum qasu, that they have given the analogy with Allah with the kings of this life. And he mentioned, وَهَذَا أَمْرٌ بَاطِلٌ, that this is something that is batil. Right? And we mentioned also another point of butlan of this, is that they take the asl to be the muluk. They take the asl to be the muluk, and they take Allah to be the far' wal-iyadu billah. Because if there is a qiyas, it must be a far' and an asl. Now here they're taking Allah to be what? To be the far' wal-iyadu billah. And they're taking the creation of Allah to be what? To be the asl. Subhanallah al-Azim. So he mentioned, وَلَيْسَ مِن تَعْظِيمِ اللَّهِ, and it is not from glorifying Allah, venerating Allah. It is not, but هُوَ مِن تَنَقُّسْ لِلَّهِ, it is to belittle Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, بِحَيْثُ إِنَّهُمْ قَاسُوهُ بِخَلْقِهِ, to the point because of that they belittle Allah because they took a qiyas with Allah to his creation. They took the creation of Allah and they made a qiyas with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with wal'iyadu billah. وَصَرَفُوا شَيْئًا مِنْ عِبَادَتِهِ, and they took some from the aspects of worship that Allah is the only one deserving to, and they gave it لِغَيْرِهِ, to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالشِّرْك, and indeed polytheism. تَنَقُّسُ لِلَّهِ, it is to belittle Allah. وَلَيْسَ تَعْظِيمًا كَمَا يَزْعُمُونَ, and it is not to glorify, to magnify, to venerate Allah as they falsely claim. ثَانِيًا, second evil issue of this particular matter is أَنَّ قِيَاس, that they have made the qiyas with Allah, عَلَى الْبَشَرِ, with the creation, with the people. And he say, this is barakallahu fikum tanaqqasu lillah, that they have indeed belittled Allah. He say, فَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَجَلَّ وَعَلَى يَعْلَمُ أَحْوَالُ عِبَادِهِ, that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is well aware of the situations. He is well aware of the actions and the statements and the different level and position of the human being. He say, وَأَمَّا اللَّهُ, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِنَّهُ إِشْ فَأَمَّا الْبَشَرِ, yes, I think I'll skip. فَأَمَّا الْبَشَرِ وَالْمُلُوكِ, as in regard to the human being and to the kings and the likes of this, فَلَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَحْوَالَ الرَّعِيَّةِ, he said that the kings and the bashar, the people, they do not know the situation of those who they have as subjects. Right? They don't know the situation of those that they have as subject. Right? Barakallahu feekum. They can do as much as intel that they want to have. Certain things, barakallahu feekum. You know what I'm saying? Listen, they let them put cameras all over your house. They can't put no camera in your brain. Right? Does Allah knows what is in your thoughts before you even thought about it? بلا شك ولا ريب. Huh, Muhammad? أما ملوك الدنيا والبشر لا يعلمون أحوال الناس. And it doesn't matter how much of a NSA that they have. Right? It doesn't matter how much of NSA that they have. Fahimt?
No.
It doesn't matter how much of those that they have. It doesn't matter how much of intel that they have. Right? Nobody can, barakallahu fikum, come into your mind and read it. Nobody. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْنَا مِنْ حَبْلٍ وَرِيدٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is closer to our jugular veins, barakallahu fikum. بِمَعْنَا أَيْ بِعِلْمِهِ وَقُدْرَتِهِ وَنُصْرِهِ. That Allah is closer to us by way of what? His knowledge, His ability, and His help and assistance. And this is no doubt about this, barakallahu al-jami'ah. Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahullah, may Allah give him good and give him a good end. He say that the muluk of this, of the muluk, meaning the kings and the bashar wal muluk, fala ya'lamuna ahwal al-ri'aya. They don't know those who they have under them, their subjects, right? He say, illa bi ahadin, except by way of a person. يبلغهم عنها لأن البشر لأنهم بشر, except by way of a person related to them, because they are human being. Right? They can't. And you know what? Allahu Akbar. During the time of the Soviet Union or the communist, nobody feels safe from anybody. You will have your son not knowing that he was hired to report against you. You will have your, and they even have this until today, barakallahu fik. Can everybody know who's their neighbor? How many times you find, right, the what you call that thing, that there's foreign company acting like they're fixing something? They ain't fixing nothing. Right? Except by a person that gotta come to do what? That tells them what is going on. Right? But alhamdulillah, some people they worry about, and you find this individual that worry about who is at the masjid, who is in the congregation. Or we might have some intruders, we might have some agent. Akhi, worry about conveying قال الله قال الرسول بما فهم السلف. You ain't gonna worry about nothing else. Marhaban bihim, wa hadha rahmatan lahum min Allah. That this is a mercy from Allah, that they will sit and listen. Perhaps that will touch their hearts. Well, people worry about, man, you know, nowadays, you know what I'm saying, you gotta watch what you say. Yeah, you gotta watch what you say. If it is not in line with the companion, now you are in trouble. That's the problem. But the problem is not who's listening to you. He's, alhamdulillah, like the brother, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rectify the affairs and give him good. One of the brother, hafidhahullah, he was saying that they in where he at, that they will not allow them to read the noble Quran. But they will allow them to read Yusuf Abdullah Ali. I say, and alhamdulillah, we told the brother, listen. If they only knew that those who have craziness in them, this is the like of those books that they will read. Yusuf Ali and them, Al-Qaradawi and those individuals. But you will not find no one reading the noble Quran and having the understanding of these issues, perpetrating these things. Only if they would have taken all of those Yusuf Ali and replace it with the noble Quran, لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ, it will be better for them. It will be better for them. It will be better for them. وَأَمَّا اللَّهُ as Allah جَلَّ وَعَلَى فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ وَلَا يَحْتَاجُ مَنْ يَبْلُغُهُ حَوَائِجُ عِبَادِهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beautiful. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does, He knows. He knows. And you know the word ma can mean two things. Lahza.
sorry? Good try, good try. Ahsanta, good try, good try. Na'am Abdullah. No, in when you look at this verse, right, the likes of this verse, yes, ma could mean negation. Like, ma sharabtu shay. Ma sharabtu shay al-yawm. Lakin sharabtu al-kahwa. Right? But here, in this particular, na'am. I thought you were going to have it. You will have, now. You have the ma, whereas it will be juz'iyya. And you'll have the ma kulliyya. A ma to indicate some. And a ma that is al-fadhil umum. Min al-fadhil umum. The ma that indicates everything. Right? The man that indicates everything. So here he mentioned, فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. That means that Allah knows every single thing, whether it moves or not, whether it has a soul or not, whether it is an animated being or not animated being, whatever it is, whether it is existing or non-existing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it. In the heavens and the earth now. Wala yahtaj, and he doesn't have no need. Na'am. Al-ma, the word ma, that is kulliya, min al-fadhil umum. Right? To mean kull, bima'na kull. Right? Min al-fadhil umum, from their generality, meaning to say everything. Nothing is being out of it. لكن كل داخل فيه. Everything is in it. And you have the ma that is juz'i. Right? It's like a partial one. Something that indicates something but not in its totality. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows everything in the heavens and the earth. And wala yahtaju, He doesn't have no need from those who will relate to Him حوائج عباده, from the needs of His servants. Allah doesn't have that need, does He? Thalithan, the third refutation in regard to the same shubuha, الشبهة الثانية, the second misconception. He mentioned the second shubuha, but the third refutation, the third way to show that this is wrong. لا عفاك الله أن الملوك الدنيا. He say, as in regard to the kings of this world, بحاجة, they are in need, أن يقبلوا شفاعة الشافعين, because the king of this world, they are in need of accepting the intercession of those who will come and intercede on their favors. They need that. The kings and the presidents and their chiefs and the likes, they need that. They need for people to come and intercede. They have a need for that. He say, لِأَنَّهُمْ بِحَاجَةٍ إِلَى الْأَعْوَانِ وَالْوُزَرَاءِ, because they are in need of assistance and ministers and helps and, you know, aids, meaning those who will work for them. They need them. Right? They need them. They need them, Barak. The president cannot do it all by himself. Right? Barakallahu fikum, the King Salman, حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ وَرَعَاهُ وَأَيَّدَهُ وَنَصَرَهُ. He cannot do it by himself. فَلِذَلِكَ, he will have withara, he will have aides, assistants, ministers, and the likes of this to aid him. He will have a bitana, even a circle of advisories. An advisor that will give him what? The good advice. Among them, the first and foremost are who? The ulama. First and foremost are the ulama, barakallahu fi. And we kulluna shahadna ala ziyarati al-malik Salman li Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahu Allah. Wa qabbala ra'sahu, Allahu akbar. Now, akhi, this is tremendous.